G'day there. Today I thought I'd take you through the RCV-3000 data logger made by Holux. And I thought I'd do a quick review of this data logger and also do some comparisons with my old Holux M1200 data logger. Compare the two. So here we go. So firstly, it's important to understand what a data logger is. So a data logger is a GPS unit wrapped up in a little box, like so. It has a couple of little lights on it to tell you what the status of things are. And what it does is it logs positions of your location and stores them in a little file, and you can transfer them to the computer. So you might think that, well, why is that particularly useful? It's useful if you're going trekking or if you're needing to record information about where you've been, but you don't need a screen to tell you where you are right now. So that's the name of data logger. So if you wanted a unit to tell you where you are now and display a map and information like that, you'd go and get a GPS. You wouldn't use one of these. So this is for showing you where you've been on the computer later on, not for showing you where you are now. And I'm doing this review on the Holux RCV-3000 because my old Holux M1200 is no longer with us. It suffered a going through the wash incident, and while the GPS side of it worked, there were parts of it that were having problems and the battery was totally stuffed, and I decided that it just wasn't worth repairing. I did have a go at repairing it. I didn't get it going, but I couldn't get it into I couldn't get the repairs into the package size to continue working with it. So I've decided to pack this in and get a new one, and so the one I've gone with is this one. Now the first thing you'll notice with the RCV-3000, and in particular when you compare it to the Holux 1200, is the physical size of it. The height of the 3000 is twice as big as the 1200. Other dimensions are pretty much the same. So the width there and the depth of them are pretty much the same. It's just simply that height. I'll show you the specs on both of them shortly, but the weight of this thing is quite a bit heavier. This thing, I believe the specs have this as weighing 50 something grams, whereas this is only 28 grams or something like that. So a substantial increase in weight in the Holux 3000. Other features of the 3000 are that it has a removable battery pack. So presumably you could go and buy other batteries, put them in, and that will extend the time that you have available to use this device if you're carrying extra batteries for it. It certainly increases the time between charges if you have more batteries. So that's a really nice feature. So a downside of the 3000 compared to the 1200 is that it lacks this button here. This is a button on the 1200, and what it lets you do is it allows you to very quickly just mark a waypoint or a point of interest on your log, which will appear on the computer screen for review at a later time. Now, in a GPS, you'd mark a position and it would show you where that position was and you could do a go to. This doesn't do that. It just allows you to mark a position of interest that you can review later on. Now, the 3000 doesn't have that button, and I see that as a real downside and a real backward step for Holux, because I believe that feature was very, very useful. It's a feature I used all the time, and it's something that I really would have liked to have seen in this unit. But alas, it's not there. Perhaps it's, a button costs money, and maybe they thought that it wasn't used or wasn't useful. But here's one user that thought that it was a very, very useful feature.
And so here's a quick view of the Holux 3000, the RCV-3000. Blue flashing light in the middle is trying to detect Bluetooth at the moment. Red solid light at the top is trying to tell you that there's no satellites being received at the moment. When it acquires satellites, that light starts to flash. And there it is, flashing away in satellite tracking mode. It's flashing there, so it's telling you that it's getting satellites. And so going through the specifications, you'll see that the two units are essentially the same. All of the satellite stuff is the same. All of the charging arrangements are the same. The two areas that are different are the power consumption. So the M1200 uses less power in operation mode than the RCV-3000. In power save mode, however, the M1200 is stated as using slightly more power than the RCV-3000. The battery capacity on the 1200 is less than the battery capacity on the RCV-3000. And the 3000, as we mentioned before, has a removable battery so that you can presumably take more than one of them and extend the life of the unit before you have to recharge. The manufacturer claims a battery life of 28 hours in the RCV-3000. I haven't tested the 28-hour battery life, and I should give that a go and put it in the comments down below. But I note that if the GPS is using more power, although it does have a bigger battery, it's also using, you know, about 30-40% more power. So I'm not sure how they get to 28 hours, given that it's using more power. Of course, the other difference that we discussed before was the size. You can see here 41 millimeters across it instead of 22, which makes it that much deeper a unit, and the weight difference, which is 32 grams for the M1200 as opposed to 53 grams for the RCV-3000, so nearly double the weight. The RCV-3000 is a little bit more expensive, and so that's a factor as well for some people. I'm just launching the logger software at the moment for both devices. The logger software works the same on both. You do need a different serial number for the RCV-3000. So you have to put the serial number for your RCV-3000 in, otherwise the software won't work. I had this problem. It took me a while to work it out that if I use the software with the serial number for the M1200 device, the software just wouldn't talk to the data logger as though there was a fault with the data logger. But it wasn't until I got the serial numbers for the software sorted out that I was able to get the program working. So the software just comes up with a Google map, or you can go over to satellite. It allows you to import files from the GPS. I'll just open up one that I've done previously. So this is a section of Antarctic. If we go over to satellite, you'll be able to see it a bit easier. So it was, take off, go to a field hut here, take off, come around back via these lakes. And you can see that I've taken some photos and I've been able to geotag those photos at those locations. It allows you to save them as Google Earth KMZ files and KML files. You can export the data to an HTML file. You can load it up to Facebook. You can do all sorts of things with this software. A bit of a trap for young players that you need to be aware of is that when you're geotagging photos with this software, the time zone on the camera needs to be the same as the time zone on the GPS. Generally, what I do is set both to UTC, and so that way it's it's exactly on. So how it works is it actually just looks at the time that the photo was taken, looks at the time on the data logger, and that's where it maps the location to. You can write the geotag information into the EXIF data for your photos, so that's really cool, and it does that quite quickly.
So I've used the 3000 in a few trips now, and I found it to be just as good as the 1200, with the exception of that button issue. Its sensitivity to receiving satellites is excellent. Its ability to remain locked onto those satellites in difficult conditions is very, very good. It's works well with the software, noting the comments that I've made about the serial number for the 3000. And overall, it's a very, very good unit. If I had a choice between the two, I probably would still go with the 1200. I didn't have that choice when it came to buying, that these just weren't available when it came to buying them. But if I had the choice, I probably would still go with the 1200 because I like that button feature. I like that it's a lot lighter. But if the weight doesn't matter to you, this is still a very good unit. Also, if battery life is important to you. So there's a review for you. Hopefully it's useful for you. Hopefully it helps you decide if you want to buy one of these or buy one of these. Certainly if you need to log your position, then Holux data loggers are very, very good. The software is excellent for transferring your data in and manipulating it and displaying it in useful forms on Facebook and Google Earth and that sort of thing. So I hope that review was useful. If you liked it, then please give it a thumbs up like that, and subscribe, tell your friends, and if you've got any questions or comments, then leave them down below in the comments, and we will catch you very soon. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.